showtime, folks.
And welcome to another episode of Into the Music. My name is Greg. I'm going to react to another song request from Arthur Woolwill. Arthur, how you doing? Long time. No, it hasn't been a long time, actually. You have steadily provided me these great song requests, but you've been a patron of the channel for such a long time, and I really appreciate that. Are you going to keep up your string of really good song requests? I don't know. You're giving me a kind of a strange... a lot of the bands and artists, the bands with these crazy names, right? But I mean, makes it really interesting, right? Poi Dog Pondering, huh? I mean, there's a meaning behind that. Poi Dog Pondering. I hope I got it right. Poi. And so the title is complicated, right? That's the name of the song, Complicated. So I have not heard of the band, nor have I heard of the title, right? So, yeah. So no more speculating on what it might be. And let me just get into it. Complicated by Poi Dog Pondering. Back the chorus coming in. I hear like the horns in the background. Might be some synth, but I like that. I like that background. Yeah, it's the buildup on this was really cool. And now it's really starting to take off. And here we go. Just to see if you said it right.
I'm scared of going through this thing twice. Wanna get it right this time. Wanna get it right.
Oh, wow. Man, that rhythm section was tremendous. That song was just moving and grooving. Such a bundle of energy. Wow. I could have listened to that like another minute or so. I mean, he's just repeating the same thing, but I mean, it was just, like I said, it was a force. Yeah, let me get my thoughts together here, and I will articulate it all, along with some information about the band, and the song, and the lyrics. Other side. Man, that band was having a grand old time with that song. I mean, they were just raising the roof. I mean, there was a buildup, even with the buildup in the beginning, you know, it kind of really came out. You know, the rhythm section really established itself right away. But that said, there was still a buildup, and then it really hit its stride, like maybe 40 seconds or so into the song. And yeah, I mean, with that line, want to get it right this time. I mean, that basically was the sort of prevailing, line, the theme going straight through. It sounds like, you know, he's taking his lumps in life and made his mistakes. And he just wants to get it right this time. Simple as that. But he was singing some other stuff too, so we'll get into the lyrics. But like I said, at the beginning, everything was kind of like building, and it came all together. The rhythm section was fantastic. I mean, the bass was really good, but the drumming, the percussion, you know, there was drums. You had some other stuff going on too. Might have been some bongos, you know, some slapping here and there. And it was just so good, but the drumming was so good. Very almost like a light touch, you know, and doing this kind of like a drum, you know, like drum rolls, but extended right into the next one, but like on a light, like a light touch, you know, nothing heavy handed at all. And there was an organ, there were keys that were sort of, you know, that, I mean, everything was kind of like, there was some pullback, the movement in, it's hard to really articulate, but, there was definitely like funk and soul that was definitely in that song, prevailing throughout. And it was just a joy. It really was, you know, you could just feel that, you know, coming, you know, emanating out of the almost, you know, that song. And as the rhythm was just moving along, you know, they were really, I guess when he's saying, I want to get it right this time, like he's feeling that positive energy. Right. And that's coming out. That's coming out in the song. You know, definitely want to just kind of get up and move and dance. Yeah. And I think that was kind of it as far as like, you know, again, there were keys and organ. I said that. And I think that's kind of it with the music part. I want to get into a little bit of the song, and kind of went into Wiki, and I wasn't really finding a lot of stuff. I mean, I found stuff about the band on Wiki, but not really about the song, except for this other website. So let me get into Wiki first and just sum up the band here. From 1984 to present. So they've been around for a while. And origins, Hawaii, Austin, Texas, Chicago, Illinois. So it's like, why all those places? But if you see the long list of members, I mean, Frank Oral, Susan Bowles. I mean, there must be like 15 people that make up this band. I don't know if all these people are current day or if they, because I mean, usually Wiki will let you know who's current and who's past, past members, not passed on. But so it's really hard to really tell. They may be all part of the band because I'm seeing a picture here of like so many people on the stage and they all have their roles, right? I mean, there's all these different instruments and some vocals, I guess, but here we go. Ponderin, Poi Dog Ponderin is an American musical group, which is noted for its cross-pollination of diverse musical genres. This is Wiki, including various forms of acoustic and electronic music. Frank Oral founded the band in Hawaii in 84, initially as a solo project. And the band embarked on a year-long street performance busking tour across North America, and that was in 85. They eventually settled down in Austin, Texas in 87, where they recorded their first three albums. In 92, the band relocated to Chicago, and they began to incorporate orchestral arrangements and elements of electronic house music and soul music, which is definitely in this song, into the acoustic rock style. So this band has definitely evolved from album to album, with Frank being a constant player since the inception of the band. And it's a lot of information, and Wiki is just given, it's kind of like given lineups from different phases of the band from like certain years. So that said, let me get into the album a bit that this is on. It's called Pomegranate, and it was released in 1995. And it's weird because there's this November 30th, 2020, is this website and it's called medium.com and they're talking about the album. So maybe this article was just published on that day, but this is about an album that was released in 1995. So Pomegranate again is the album. Attempting to label the music of Chicago-based Poi Dog Ponderin is a bit of a fool's errand. That's how the article starts off. At times, their sound is a bit folky, at times a bit rock and roll, and at other times a bit house and electronic. They're a tough band to label. Poi Dog Ponderin is a little bit of everything, and as a result, its own thing. That's a great way to describe. I really wouldn't know just based off this one song, but I'm definitely intrigued. I'd like to hear more from this band. It talks about leaving Hawaii. And Poi Dog Ponderin was, oh, so that was 1989, not 95. It's really confusing. And this was recorded by Columbia Records. So they had actually a really big album deal there. That's a big deal when you're, at that time, when you were recording for Columbia. And they talk about this song here, Complicated, and they're really talking about the range of the album, from folky, rock, dreamy music, and then you get into kind of smooth acoustic, and then it says it glides right into the downright joyous Complicated. Yeah, I think I actually used the word joy. Yeah, it was just joy that was just coming out of the music. So there you go. Cool. Arthur, you hit it again, man. I really enjoyed this. This one was really fun. And like I said, I felt happy. And I wanted to, I mean, you saw me. I'm sure when you look at the reaction, I'm moving. So that's what the music was doing to me. So I'm really intrigued to see what else is from this group. And in the meantime, Arthur and everyone out there, let me know what you think about this reaction. And what is that next song from this group that I should react to? Or at least, you know, sort of point me in that right direction. And in the meantime, I'll see every one of you on the next episode of Into the Music.